Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about different categories of Miller indices, and whenever required I will discuss about Weiss indices also. But before watching this video, I will strongly recommend you to watch my previous video on Weiss indices and Miller indices. Link of that video is given here. So Miller indices is mainly categorized into three types. First one is one coordinate system, which is also known as 100. Second one is two coordinate system, which is also known as 110, and the third one is three coordinate system, which is also known as 111. So coming to the first one, that is one coordinate system. So this is the representation for one coordinate system. Now question is that what is one coordinate system? It means this plane will create intercept only in one axis. Either it may be x or it may be y or it may be z. Rest two will be parallel. So if we are talking about 100, then it is categorized, means there are three possibilities, that is 100, 010, and third one is 001. So these are the three possible Miller indices, and it will be present in the bracket. If we are talking about 100, so here it will create intercept on x axis and rest to y and z will be parallel, just like this. This is the example of 100. If we are talking about 010, then it will create intercept on y axis and this will be parallel to the x axis and z axis. If we are talking about 001, then it will create intercept only on z axis and it will be parallel to the x axis and y axis. So this is the example of 100. If we will take 010, then this face will be there. If we are taking 001, then this face will be there. Now there is possibility of planes in negative sides also. So it will be 100, it will be 1 bar 00. 1 bar means minus 1, and it will be 0 1 bar 0, and it will be 0 0 1 bar. So in this family total 6 members are there, that is 100, 1 bar 00, 010, 0 1 bar 0, 001, 001 bar. So here in 100 it will be H, it will be K, and it will be L. Similarly, x axis represents to H, y axis represents to K, and z axis represents to L. Now if you want to take the Weiss indices of the same, then it will be reversed. This is Weiss indices, the WI. So 1 by 1 will be 1, 1 by 0 will be infinite, and 1 by 0 will be again infinite. So the in Weiss indices, this one is A, this one is B, and this one is C. Similarly here it will be infinite, 1, infinite, A, B, C. Similarly here it will be infinite, infinite, 1. It is A, B, and C. Now if you want to see the 3D representation of the same for better visibility, then it is visible in your screen. Now coming to the second category, that is two coordinate system, which is represented by 110.
So
So this is the representation for two coordinate system, which is represented by 110. So main members of 110 are 3, that is 110, 101 and 001. All this will be present in the bracket. Now if you will take the negative planes, so here this 110 is categorized into three parts, that is 1 bar 10, 1 1 bar 0, and the third one is 1 bar 1 bar 0. Similarly here also 1 bar 01, 1 0 1 bar, 1 bar 0 1 bar, and similarly here also it will be 011. So it will be 0 1 bar 1 0 1 1 bar 0 1 bar 1 bar. Now if we will take vice indices of the same, that is represented by WI, so it will be 1 by 1 is equal to 1, 1 by 1 is equal to again 1, 1 by 0 is equal to infinite. Here it will be, here it is A, B and C. Now here 1 by 1 is equal to 1, 0 by 1 0 by 1 by 0 is equal to infinite, then again 1, it is A, B and C, and here also it will be infinite 1 1, it is A, B, C. And here if we will talk about this x-axis, then it will be H, this will be K and this will be L. Now coming to the term two coordinate system. So here in one coordinate system, it is creating intercept in only one axis. So here this two coordinate system will create intercept in two axis. If you will take the example of this plane, then it is creating intercept on x axis as well as y axis, and it is parallel to the z axis. If you will take the example of 101, then it will create intercept on x axis and z axis, and it will be parallel to the y axis. If you will take the example of 011, then it will create intercept on y axis and z axis, and it will be parallel to the x axis. If you want to see the 3D representation of the same, then it is visible in your screen. Now coming to the third category, that is three coordinate system, which is represented by 111. So this is the representation for three coordinate system, which is 111, and this 111 is subcategorized into 7 types, which will be like this. So first one is 1 bar 1 1, so here all will be present in the bracket because it is Miller indices. Now second one is 1 1 bar 1, third one is 1 1 1 bar, fourth one is 1 bar 1 bar 1, fifth one is 1 1 bar 1 bar, sixth one is 1 bar 1 1 bar, and the last one is 1 bar 1 bar 1 bar. And if you will take vice indices of the same, then it will be 1 by 1 is equal to 1, 1 by 1 is equal to again 1, and 1 by 1 is equal to again 1. This is A, this is B, this is C. Now what is the meaning of these three coordinate system? It means it will create intercept on all three axes, that is x, y and z. So here you can see that this 111 is creating intercept on x axis, in y axis as well as in z axis. It means this plane is cutting all these three axes, which is visible in your screen in 3D diagram. Now I will take some Miller indices value from 1 coordinate, 2 coordinate and the 3 coordinate system. Then I will draw the plane for the same. So taking the first one, that is 200. So here you can see that Miller indices is 200. It means H, K and L is equal to 200. So first we have to convert these Miller indices into Weiss indices, that is Wi. So it will be 1 by 2, 1 by 0 and 1 by 0. So we can say that Weiss indices is inverse of Miller indices, or Miller indices is inverse of Weiss indices. So it will be equal to 1 by 2 infinite in the infinite. Now we will plot this value in the cubic structure, which will be like this. So here, as per the given data, it will create half intercept. So in x axis, so it will be half. Now it will be parallel to the z and parallel to the y. So we will draw parallel to the y, so it will be like this. And again it is saying parallel to the z, so parallel to the z will be like this. So now we will create plane from these two lines, so it will be like this. So this is the representation for 200, that is Miller indices 200. And if you will compare this plane and this plane, then both are parallel, but interplanar distance in this plane and this plane is different. If you will see through 3D, then it will be clearly visible, which is visible in your screen. Now coming to the second example, that is 220 from 2 coordinate system. So here you can see that it is 220, means Miller indices is 220. It means H, K and L is 2, 2 and 0. Now if you will find the Weiss indices for the same, then it will be inverse of it. It means it will be 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 1 by 0. So ultimately it will be equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and infinite. Now if we will represent this data in the cubic structure, then it will be visible like this. So this is the cubic structure. In any cubic structure, you can take any axis as x, y, z. You can take this as x, this as y, this as z. You can take this z as x, y, z, anything you can take. Now coming to this data. So it is in x axis, or h is equal to half. So let's take h is equal to half. Now coming to the second one, that is K, or y is equal to again half. So in y axis we will take again this will be the half of this portion. Now coming to the z axis, so z axis is parallel to it, so z axis will be parallel. So z axis is parallel, x and y are half. Now we can plot plane from these two line and it will be like this. So this is the representation for 220. Now if you will compare this 220 with 110, then both are parallel. Here it is not clearly visible. If you will see through 3D representation, then it will be clearly visible, which is visible in your screen. Now coming to the third example, which is from three coordinate system, and that is 2 2 2. So Miller indices is 2 2 2. It means H, K and L is equal to 2 2 2. Now if we will find out the Y's indices of this same, then it will be inverse of it, so it will be 1/2, 1/2 and 1/2. Now if you will plot this data in a cubic structure, then it will be like this. So here you can see that this one is x axis, this one is y axis, and this one is z axis, and this one is origin. So if you will see through this data, or if you will go through this data, then it is creating intercept on x axis at half, 1/2. So this is 1/2 part of x axis. Now if you will go through the y axis, which is k, so it is again present in the half portion. So this will be the half portion in y axis. Now if you will go through the L or Z axis, then it will be again creating intercept at half portion. So approximately this will be the half portion. Now we will join all these three points and it will create a plane which will be like this. Now if you will see this plane and this plane, then both are parallel. If you will see through 3D representation, then it will be clearly visible, which is visible in your screen. So in these examples we have seen that 100 and 200 are parallel, 110 and 220 are parallel, 111 and 222 are parallel. So what is difference between all of this? So if we will see through the direction, then 100 and 200 are same, 110 and 220 are same, and 111 and 222 are same. So if we are taking the direction, then all these three pairs are same, and this is the definition of Miller indices. But if we will take the interplanar distance between all these planes, then all these pairs are different, and that can be defined by using the formula DHKL is equal to A by under root H square plus K square plus L square. So by using this formula, that is DHKL is equal to A by under root H square plus K square plus L square, we can differentiate between these pairs. So here A is equal to edge length and H is equal to length of this one from this point to this point. K is equal to from this point to this point and L is equal to from this origin to this point. Now if we are taking the value of D100 or this one, then what will be the D value? So it will be equal to A divided by under root 1 square plus 0 square plus 0 square. So ultimately it will be equal to A by under root 1 square and 1 square is equal to 1 plus 0 plus 0. So ultimately it will be under root 1 and under root 1 is equal to 1. So it will be A by 1 or it will be equal to A. Now if we are talking about this one, D200, so it will be A by under root 2 square plus 0 square plus 0 square and ultimately it will be A divided by under root 2 square is equal to 4 plus 0 plus 0. So 4 plus 0 plus 0 is equal to 4 and under root 4 is equal to 2. So here you can see that in D100 it is equal to A, but in D200 it is A by 2. That's why here it is present in the front position and it is making intercept on x axis at 1, but here it is making intercept on x axis is 1 by 2. So here it is 1 by 2 A. Now coming to the second one, that is 110. So D110 is equal to A by under root 1 square plus 1 square plus 0 square. So ultimately it will be A by 1 square is equal to 1 plus 1 square is equal to 1 plus 0 square is equal to 0. So 1 plus 1 plus 0 is equal to 2. It will be under root 2. Now if we are talking about 220, then it will be D220 is equal to A by under root 2 square plus 2 square plus 0 square. So ultimately it will be equal to A by 2 square is equal to 4 plus 2 square is equal to 4 plus 0 square is equal to 0. So 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. So it will be under root 8. So here you can see that D110 is 1 by under root 2, means interplanar distance is 1 A by under root 2 and here interplanar distance is A by under root 8. Now if we are talking about this 111, then it will be like this. D111 is equal to A by under root 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square. So ultimately it will be equal to A by 1 square is equal to 1 plus 1 square is equal to 1 plus 1 square is equal to 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to A by under root 3. If we are talking about this one, so it will be D222 is equal to A by under root 2 square plus 2 square plus 2 square. So it will be equal to A by 2 square is equal to 4 plus 4 plus 4. So it will be under root 12. So this is the details about different categories of Miller indices and their representation in Weiss indices also. Now in my next video, I will discuss about some negative Miller indices like this one. Thank you.